Get ready to match the stars. Robert Moore, Brett Somers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Adrienne Barbeau, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Fly as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now the star of Match Game 74, Gene Rivers.
Thank you, Johnny Olson. Thank you, dear friend. Now, what is going on here?
Nothing. Oh, it's my wig.
Well?
My name is Bachelor Number 3.
Hi, I'm on the wrong show.
Yes. You do that fella, don't you? He does a very good imitation.
No, I actually do Stanley.
Oh, you do Stanley. That's right. Yeah.
Not bad.
All right. Okay, we got that out of the way. And if you're ready, we'll have a go at it by meeting our two players over here, Phil Perrell and Arlene Primisario. How are you, Phil?
Hi, how are you?
Good. Arlene?
Hi.
Phil's our current champion. He's won a lot of money. He's got $4,050 to his credit, and I guess you're happy about that, right?
Oh, I'm real happy about it.
What are you going to do with all that money, Phil?
Spend it.
You're going to spend it? That's it. You're going to beat this inflation single-handedly, aren't you?
I'm going to try.
Okay, and Arlene, you've got, let's see, now you've had your second-round question, haven't you?
Yeah.
And you've had one match, and you've got a second-round question coming up here, and one match for you will win another game for you. That'll be your third game, right? Fourth game. Okay, we'll see how that turns out in a moment or so, but right now, we got a little message for you, friends. This is it. Now, we're ready to carry on here with the middle of round two. Last question in this game. Phil, you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, remember, one to win is all you need. Josephine sneezed so hard that her blank turned inside out.
Bless you.
Gesundheit. Josephine sneezed so hard that her blank turned inside out. Sounds like an old song that I used to sing in my childhood.
What was it? How'd it go?
It was a song about down by the hen house on my knees. Oh, Mona, I thought I heard a chicken sneeze. Oh, Mona, Mona, you shall be free. Hallelujah, if the good Lord sets you free.
Thank you very much, Bachelor Number 1.
Where in New Jersey is?
All right, y'all ready? I was just vamping till ready. Fanny, are you still writing? I could do another chorus there. All right, Phil. Josephine sneezed so hard that her blank turned inside out.
Her bra.
Well, all right. That was rather surprising.
I'm very sorry about this.
What?
Insides.
Her insides turned inside out. Okay. Okay. One C cup will win the game for you.
How soon can we get him on the bus? My Josephine had a very small bosom, but a very large...
Yes, we understand.
Blank. So I said corset.
Her corset turned inside
out. She didn't wear a bra.
Okay, well, you're getting close to. You got one.
I said her girdle.
Her girdle.
Inside.
All right, looking for a bra here.
This is not a bra. I said her nose.
Her nose turned inside out. That was some sneeze, wasn't it? And
her
Fanny.
Nose.
Yeah.
I don't know.
That's what I said.
Her nose.
Oh, it's a tie, Brett.
We got a tie. You gonna cry? Well, you don't have to cry. We got a tie here. Don't tie for the cry. One to one, we'll wipe the slate clean.
Watch up, Doc.
I sneezed pretty hard, too. My uppers came out. Yeah. All right, I'll push this button here and reveal our tie-breaking question. One for each, and the one who has the most will be the winner. Arlene, please make a selection.
A.
A. She's chosen A every time.
Yes.
Uh-huh. When Tom...
A for blank.
When Tom finished showing his vacation movies... He turned the lights back on and discovered his guests were all blanking.
What?
Now,
listen
to it carefully.
To
now.
Me.
Tom finished showing his vacation movies. He turned the lights back on and discovered his guests were all blanking.
Oh, you little cute devil.
Yes. All right. Now, they're finished there.
I'm finished.
Oh, you're finished. Oh, you're just writing a note home, are you? Okay, Arlene, when Tom finished showing his vacation movies, he turned the lights back on and discovered his guests were all blanking.
Sleeping.
Robert, she said that in a rather pleading tone.
Yes.
She's pleading with you to say sleeping.
Sleeping.
You're sleeping, okay. Brett?
To be perfectly frank, I never thought that child would get her act together. But by golly, she did.
She did. Okay. Charles?
She certainly did.
She did indeed. Wow, that's three. What do you say, Ben?
I'm sorry, Arlene. They were leaving.
Leaving? Go to your room.
My guests are much more active.
And Richard?
Yes, they were leaving. They were leaving a call because they were sleeping.
Sleeping. That's four. Fanny.
Sleeping.
Well, you got five out of six, Arlene, and you've got a job cut out for you, Phil. Mm-hmm. And we'll see how it turns out in a moment or so. But, friends, we've got this for you right now. Now, we're ready to carry on here. We've got a question for you, and this is it. Listen carefully. You need five to tie, six to win. Everybody plays.
Okay.
Larry said to the psychiatrist, "When I'm home alone and I'm positive no one will see me, I pretend to be a blank." Larry said to the psychiatrist, "When I'm home alone and I'm positive no one will see me, I pretend to be a blank."
Okay.
Well, I do that occasionally.
You do that?
When I'm alone. Yeah.
When you're alone. Okay. No talking up there, children.
Well, they already have.
Yeah.
You know me, honey. I only talk to you.
Okay. Now, they're all set. So, Phil, we need a response from you. Larry said to the psychiatrist, "When I'm home alone and I'm positive no one will see me, I pretend to be a..."
Woman.
Woman. All right.
A girl.
There's one match. Brett?
Well, I'm too young to think in terms of womanhood.
Oh.
So I said girl.
Naturally. And you?
We know what he said.
I know you do.
Oh, Charles.
May I see Dr. Farnsworth immediately? I said a goyle.
A goyle. That's three. Two more to tie. Let's see if it happens.
Well, Adrienne. I was going to say Charles Nelson Reilly, but I said a girl.
You said a girl. Okay, that's four.
One more. Showing affection.
The papers came early today, didn't
they?
Makes a change from throwing them on the lawn.
Now, one more for a tie. Richard, it's up to you.
One more what?
For a lawsuit.
One more match to tie the game.
You're not just putting me on?
No.
Well, I'm going to make sure it's not upside down. Because
that's right. Go! Now, it's really up to you. One more will win the game for him.
Pressure. High blue eyes.
That wins the game. Congratulations. Come on down. Okay, Phil, here we go again. Now, Arlene, a gift for you together with our thanks. That was a close one, wasn't it?
It would have been a bonus if I won. It was just a pleasure to be here.
Well, I thank you very much. Oh, it's great meeting you, Arlene Polisario. Goodbye. That's the little bear she brought me. Yes, you did. All right, Phil, you've done it again. That's your fourth game. You got $4,150. You're going to try for another $5,500 potentially here. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, we polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Earth blank? The answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match that. Now, if you match the next most frequently given answer, it's $250, and the third, $100. Three celebrities are allowed to help. Whom do you choose?
Richard.
Quake.
Earthquake.
Earthquake is one.
Adrienne.
Earthworm.
Earthworm. That's two. They like that one.
Brett.
And Brett.
What you are, dear, say it.
Earth Mother.
Earth Mother. Earth Mother of us all.
Or
that's
if
Brett.
If you prefer, Mother Earth.
Now you've got Earth Mother, Earthworm.
Or Mother Filth.
Earthquake.
Mr. Dirt.
You may choose one of those or give us one of your own. What do you want to do?
Earthquake.
Earthquake is the one that we are looking for. Let's find out if it's up there. And if it's up there, where is it? Is it under the $100 response? No, it isn't.
Oh.
Earth Angel.
Angel.
Earth Angel.
Earth Angel. Oh, yeah. What's that? The song, right? Okay. We're looking for Earthquake. Is it under the $250 response? Earthworm is there. That's the one Adrienne gave you. All right. Last chance for Earthquake.
Right on.
Let's see if the set shakes as we reveal the $500 response. Look at the set shaking.
Get out of here. Get out of here. Get.
I'll see you next time.
Don't let him interfere with our love affair.
If anybody's going to...
Look at that little rascal.
Oh, that's up. Get him out.
Man's having an affair on our time.
That's right, and he's getting paid for it. You're the kissiest guy we've ever had on this show.
I love that pen.
Anybody's going to kiss her, it's going to be me. Is that clear? Okay.
Gene,
right.
You tell that boy to keep his hands off my daughter.
Okay. Now you're going to have a go at $5,000 here. You're going to play for 10 times 500. Now, you've got to match one celebrity exactly in order to collect. Whom will it be?
Okay, Richard, let's try.
All right. Now, you face me. You ready to write, Richard?
Yeah.
It's worth $5,000, and this
Gene,
is it.
Gene, tell Charles to sit down.
No, I like this part.
He wants to know what's going on. Blank. Hello. Ring. R-I-N-G. Everyone's wondering what you've written, including Phil, who's going to give us an answer now which he thinks will match yours. What do you say?
Wedding ring.
Wedding ring. All right, for $5,000, Richard, may we see your response?
Yeah. Just before the wedding, what do you give a girl?
Engagement ring.
Engagement ring.
And you marry her.
No! Then you marry her. So you're okay, we got $9,650. And you get ready to play another game, but right now we got to play a game with our audience in America. Here we go. Okay, we're ready to have a go at it here. Start another game. Ready, Phil?
I am ready.
Okay, let's meet your new opponent. Here is Marva Farmer. Hi, Marva.
Hi, how are you?
How are you? You know Phil?
Yeah.
Whoops. Isn't she pretty?
Oh.
You're a very pretty lady, Marva.
Thank you.
Where are you from?
Atlanta, Georgia.
Hey! There's another
honey,
one
you're
there.
Not from Atlanta, Georgia. You're from Birmingham, Alabama.
She's been
she
there.
Keeps
she's
forgetting.
From the South. You live here now?
Yes, I do.
What else you want to tell us about Marva?
Well, I'm not that interesting. I'm not married. I'm interested.
That's interesting.
That's the most interesting thing
you've
said all day,
today.
Right?
First interest I've had in a farmer for a long time.
And I have been a computer programmer.
Yeah. Yes. And you live here now?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's nice to have you here on Match Game 74, Marva.
Thank you. I'm happy
you ready?
To be here. Yes, I
good.
Think so.
Let's begin. Now, would you please make a selection?
I think I'll pick A.
A it is. First.
I'm a stranger in town, Marva. Could you direct me to your house?
You'd
be surprised how many times that works.
Got a little riddle for you, Marva.
Okay.
Are you ready for a little riddle?
Yeah.
What's small and green and covered with red spots? The answer, a blank with measles.
Small, green.
Small, green, covered with red spots. And the answer is a blank with measles.
Oh.
Small and green. Red spots. Okay.
Isn't it a shame about Marva's face?
Yes.
And her smile.
Plastic surgery can fix her up, though.
You know, Marva Farmer's lovely, but I don't believe all the stories about her.
What's, oh, really?
Well, she is Farmer's daughter.
Oh, yes, of course. All right, Marva, you ready for this? A little
you
riddle.
You can't win them all, Charles.
What's small and green and covered with red spots? The answer, a blank with measles.
I said a little green pea.
A little green pea. Okay. That's cute. Yeah, that's a good answer. Robert, what'd you say?
Marva, you and I are on the same wavelength because I said pea too.
Good for you. Good for you. Small and green and covered with red spots. All right, that's it, Brett.
What about a little green Martian?
A little green Martian. Okay, that'll work. Charles?
Marva is the farmer's daughter.
Yeah.
I'll get a laugh and applause anyway.
All right, there it is. That's true for you. Well, it's working for you, isn't it? Okay, Brienne.
Well, farmers farm worms. I don't know.
You don't know.
He says worms aren't green. I'm really wrong.
No, no, there are. There are a lot of green.
I've seen a couple of green worms in my house so far.
I Maybe married a green worm.
That's what I'm saying. I said a pickle.
A pickle.
When they get measles, it's sad.
Oh. Yeah. Okay, Fanny.
We had one die at our house.
I don't think they're playing the game.
Temperature.
A pickle can't get the measles.
What can?
A frog.
A frog.
Frog can get the measles.
Okay, so that's two for you in the first round, and let's see how Phil does with his first round question. Again, everybody plays. Dumb Dora said.
Mm-hmm.
Dumb Dora said, I'm going to put my blank in the Xerox machine. And then I'll have two. I'm going to put my blank in the Xerox machine. And then I'll have two.
Okay.
Oh, boy.
You're on your own, folks.
Curtain up.
Light the lights.
Don't ask me.
Come now, you can do better than
can
that.
Can I do better than
you
that?
You can do better than that. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Already up here?
None of your business.
All set, okay.
I can't. Oh, gotta go again? Wait a minute.
Okay, time's up. All right, Phil. Dumb Dora said, I'm going to put my blank in the Xerox machine, and then I'll have two.
Boom.
What?
What
oh, really?
She had problems. Oh.
You said boom. Okay.
Boob?
Yeah, a boob.
One boob.
Yep.
Unos abubos.
Right, that's it. Right. Just show the card, that's it.
I said a head.
One head, two head of Dumb Dora. All right, Brett.
Well, that's how I got two.
Oh.
I put my bun.
Oh, all right. In. Okay.
That isn't a match.
No, it's not a match. Charles.
How about this?
No, wrong.
I went a different way. I said my dollar.
Oh, that's good. Yeah, put a dollar in the middle. Oh. $2.
Well, I figured it was up for grabs. I said cheek. I don't know
her
what
cheek.
That means.
Her cheek.
Yeah,
that'd be great. Yeah, then she
cheeks.
Could turn the other...
Cheek, yes, yes, of course, Richard.
Oh, it's my pleasure. Boyfriend.
Boyfriend.
Ah. Uh-huh. Nobody's fool.
Dumb Dora was not as dumb as we thought.
Carry but... one in the wallet.
Right. Yes, Fanny.
I was totally confused. I thought it was Larry.
Larry?
Larry.
His wife.
It was Dumb Dora.
I
said Dumb Dora.
I know it. I got confused.
Boy, are you dumb.
I know it.
You are dumb.
She spelled
D-U-M.
It right, though.
Yes.
I spelled it right.
Okay. Good. So that's 2-0 at the end of round one, and round two coming up in a moment or so. But right now, friends, we've got to pass along this message. Well, listen, it's the end of round one, and you're ahead 2-0.
And I feel good.
And it makes you feel good, doesn't it?
It does.
You got $9,650.
I like that. I like it.
That must make you feel good. And you've kissed all these girls, including, you've kissed all these people up here, and it's, including her. Is there anything, what happened to, what's his name?
He passed over to the other side.
What's his name? Oh. What are you doing there, Robert?
I was getting one of these funny cigarettes. So.
It's not allowed.
Are we on?
Yeah, we're on.
Oh, hi.
Say goodbye. Say goodbye, Bobby.
Mommy?
He doesn't do it, really.
That's what happened to his own show. When he came back, it had been canceled. Why don't you be nice and say goodnight to everybody?
Okay, goodnight, everybody. It was splendid of you to join us, and we hope you'll join us next time for Match Game 74. My name is Gene Rayburn. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 74, a Mark Goodson, Bill Tubman production.